Hey boys, welcome back to some more spin bowling career mode, taking on, I always start the video like that, even though I have no idea who we're versing. We're versing Jamaica. They've got Chris Gayle as well. So yeah, this is before, I've said it before, this is before the patch. We got a couple of duplicates there. But they have Joe Wardner, Chris Lynn was in the side. Yeah, so you'll see Chris Gayle's on both sides, before the patch number 3. And, yeah, hopefully we can continue our good form. It's funny, I think the team I chose is the only one that doesn't have, like, the proper kits. Like, all the other teams, I think, have, like, the correct kits. Maybe there's a couple that don't, but I chose one of the teams that do not, which is a little annoying, but, you know, it's not too bad. As, we're gonna actually field the first ball here, see what he does. He goes for a sneaky little shot down to the gully region there. Don't know what the hell I'm doing, but I'm excited nonetheless. We're going to simulate. Wyatt there gets a huge score. And we're coming on in the 20th over. Joe Wardner is 62. Chris Lynn is new to the crease, but we're coming on to bowl the final over. No warm-ups, just come in and do the job, I guess. I don't know. I don't know why they didn't bring me on earlier. I didn't see the pitch. The pitch is probably not suited for spin bowling, I guess, but they are turning to me to bowl the last over, so he's got enough faith in me for that. I think I'm actually the captain, so I guess it's sort of my fault, but the funny thing is, like, when you simulate, it goes, like, so quickly. It's sometimes I always forget to, like, stop this simulation. It goes too quick, but generally, you know, I'll come on before this, but, you know, it's all right. We'll bowl one over. It's going to be a big total to chase. It's been a good over. You know, we're restricting it, hopefully below 190, which would be good. A decent shot there by Joe Wardner, but only the single. So, you know, good stuff, good stuff. Hopefully just a couple of runs coming off this over, which would be very, very nice. Chris Lynn, new to the crease. Probably spinners in his favourite, you know, bowling to come up against, but Tries a big shot there. We're trying to get across, but it's not even going to be a catch. It's one of those times, dude. It always confuses me. It bounces way too high off the pitch, like, honestly. But that is going to be their innings done. Wyatt there, Chris Gayle getting a few, and Joe Wardner, the bulk of the run scorers. So our own Chris Gayle is coming in. Hopefully he can do somewhat similar at the top of the order, but it looks like we've had a bit of a collapse. We come in here with a 24 average, you know, not too bad for T20s, but we'd like to boost it up a bit. And it looks like Bravo is in with us at the crease. We try a reverse sweep straight up. I don't know what's doing there, but the run rate is on track. It's just the 3 wickets down in the 8th over is not good. Chris Gayle, of all people, has got 2 for 10 into his second over here. So, you know, they bring on the part-timer, Chris Gayle. And he gets a couple of wickets as we go for the risky 2. You know, that sort of stuff probably shouldn't be doing, but, you know, we do pick it up. If it was a direct hit, he would have been gone, but we do get the 2. And we just got to work our way into the innings. It hasn't started too well, honestly. A couple of plays and misses. A fairly rusty 2 there, but, you know, I felt in pretty good form. The last couple of games, we've been batting pretty well, so this is a good chance to actually, you know, win, or potentially, you know, get us into a winnable position. Because at the moment, you know, we're definitely not in the box seat here. But Bravo's going along nicely. We're struggling quite a bit, 5 off 9. But that is a nice shot. That hopefully will get us into a bit of rhythm. Just a bit over pitch there by Gayle, using the feet, getting to it on the full, and taking it long over mid off there. No one back straight, so a fairly safe shot. As this one try to sweep, way too far outside off, you know, just just as innings, dude, just not really focusing. Like, with, you know, with Don Bradman cricket in general, you just gotta focus on the ball. You know, you gotta focus where the line is, where the length is, that sort of stuff. As once again, I don't know why I was so obsessed with the reverse sweeps this innings, but I was trying to do them. They weren't paying off. You know, I'm probably just lucky that I'm not getting out to them this time. Just a nice conventional sweep. Almost run our partner out again, but he does make the ground safely, so all good. This time, Thomas here coming in over pitches and worked beautifully off the pads there for a nice forward. Actually swung a bit late, but two full toss, so very easily put away there. And we do move on to 16, Bravo on 17. So it's been a good little consolidation period here. Not taking any, well, too many risks. I mean, we haven't butted very well, but right here we're gonna get extremely lucky. Look at this, 4 overthrows. Terrible work by the fielders. He throws it at the stumps. The keeper, I don't know what he's doing. The backup, nowhere to be seen as well. So we'll take it, dude. We move on to 20. So that was very, very nice. Very nice indeed. We were struggling a little bit to get going, but all of a sudden should be back-to-back-to-back fours off this over. So this is a big over. Thomas there cranking it up. 156K. I don't know who this dude is, but he's bowling pretty quick. It's been a fairly costly over, though. You know, you gotta feel a little sorry for him. 4 overthrows, which should have been a dot ball, but he's gonna finish with 17 coming off the over, or 18 with the bye, but 17 to his figures as Victor, the spinner, coming back in. And all of a sudden, we found a little bit of rhythm here. Just a big 6 over log on. That over before with 4 fours in a row definitely got us into got our confidence up, got us looking pretty decent at the crease. This time just working the single, getting, you know, just working the strike, getting Bravo on strike. He's batting along nicely. Unfortunately, though, he did get out, so his brother now, Dwayne? Who was that before? Darren. It must have been Darren Bravo. So now Dwayne Bravo is at the crease. Unfortunately, it was a good partnership. It is a shame that he did get out in that situation, but obviously, Dwayne Bravo is no mug with the bat. We definitely got some good depth at the crease. So, you know, we just got to continue to play well. Play well, honestly. And we have hit some form. So, 37 off 24. The run rate has picked up just tenfold, honestly. We were striking at like 100 before. So, it's definitely improved. This time, Thomas once again bangs it in short. We do charge him. He's pretty quick, but we do get enough on that. It was one of those times I was a little worried because, you know, you can easily just hole out to the mid-wicket or the square leg with one of those, but move into the 40s now with that decent shot as Thomas here winds up. And this time, just hit telling, man, we get an easy single. Good stuff by Bravo, just getting in the way of that one. As another quick bowler, Reese here, far out. All these dudes cranking it up to 150, but using the feet this time. He over pitches, hit it through that vacant cover area. There's no one back there. They got a fairly attacking field. I mean, they can have this attacking field with 4 out. They're probably, I mean, it's pretty tight. Like, I don't know who you'd say is in front of this time. You know, we're chasing 180 odd. You'd probably say they're in the box seat, honestly. Like, we require a fair few runs to get the win here. Is this one is, I think, just going to trickle over the rope there. I thought it was going to be just a couple of runs, but that is our 50. 51 of 29, so very, very good strike rate. There's the required 56 of 29, so that's, it's doable. And with shots like that, it's going to be, we're going to make it look easy. But yeah, it's still a challenge. I mean, if we get out now, I sort of feel like we're going to lose, so We've got to stay in there. We got to see this one through to the end. Obviously, Bravo can do his job at the crease as well. This one, a poor ball. Honestly, if I just stayed in the crease, it probably would have just swung down leg and been a wide, but we do hit it for another 6. So this was the over. As soon as I saw like the required being like 59 off whatever it was, I was like, man, we actually have to get a few boundaries here. So we start the over off very, very nicely. 4-6-6. That's exactly what you want. And we used the attacking field to our advantage. We got those boundaries. They did spread the field back right now. So, you know, we used it while we could, honestly. And this one hit back with a point. I couldn't believe there was no fielders back there. I thought it was just going to be one or maybe two, but it's going to go for 4. So it's been a huge over. That tally looked very, very difficult to start the over. But now 40 off 25. Still difficult, but we brought it back down to way below what it should have been. And we're going to take a sneaky single. The fielder, my goodness, everyone must have been furious at that. The fielder was just so slow onto the ball. As we look at our wagon wheel, pretty much, you know, down the ground. A couple on the leg side, but not too much elsewhere. Just very dominant from that, you know, in the arc there, down the ground. This one, though, overpitched again by Reese. It's going to be hit away for four. There's no one back there, so it's a very safe shot and a very, very rewarding shot at that. Full toss on the pads. I mean, you just can't do it. They got no one back there. There's no square leg. There's no mid wicket. There's no fine leg. So we have creeped over a little bit to off stump, just trying to play there. But this time we just take it straight back over his head. We didn't time it too well, but he's going to go for four. It's a pretty short boundary out there. So, you know, good stuff. Move into the 70s now. 76. We actually have a chance of getting 100. I mean, if we stay out here the whole time and we get the winning runs, then we're a very good shot of actually getting the 100. This time we just work it off the pads. A beautiful shot. Just flicks it for a couple of bounces for four. So, we just, honestly, it's like a totally different game. The first like 20 balls I faced, I mean, I wasn't really hitting them too well. A couple of fours in that, maybe 1-6, but the rest of the time, this time again, just flicking it off the pads. It's bad bowling, honestly. Just like three balls this over have been on the pad. That's a 50-run partnership. Bravo has got five of those, so it's been a fairly dominant performance. But yeah, ever since that, you know, pretty much the overthrows, he got the four. It was a bit of a relief. I don't know, I felt good. As soon as the overthrows happened, I thought, this is our game. We've got the luck running it with us, so we got to use it to our advantage. And it's been a huge over. Just incredible stuff. We brought the run rate up back to just over 6 and over. So, you know, excellent, excellent couple of overs. 86 now. And we are going to come back here. Two overs remaining. The last over was pretty, you know, not great. I sort of didn't really run too many. I sort of just let Bravo hit a few dots, but, you know, that's fine. I felt in control. I wanted to get the potential to get the 100, and it is going to, what do we need? 15 off 11, so, you know, the run rate didn't blow up by any means, and we move into the 90s now. This time we charge. It was one of those times where you sort of charge, and it's so slow. Even though it was a quick ball, we played it so early, I guess. But looking to go long again over mid-off cover region. That's sort of our area here. But he bangs it in short this time. We play along the ground, which is probably smart because they did have a man back there. And we're going to pick up two. So a very good outcome right there. 13 off 9. You know, we can pretty much cruise home from here. As long as if we get out now, it could get tight, but if we stay in, it's a sure thing. This time, going over cover, inside out, they had no one back there. You know, they sort of had a few men on the leg side. They sort of were trying to get on the pads, go straight, but just sort of went inside out. Beautiful shot over the man at cover there. And we move on to 97, so we can get it with one shot here. What are we going to do? The short one, we hit it square, and we're going to take the single, so good stuff. And I'm pretty sure we just see the dot out for Bravo there. So we got one over to get this 100, get the win. And we blast that one through wide mid on. He's not going to get there. The man didn't have too far to go, but that is going to be a four. That is going to be the 100. 102 or 48. This has been a match-winning innings. It's probably the best innings I've played. I don't know. I mean, we played some good ones in the first class, but for T20s, for sure, this has been match-winning. It's been incredible stuff. You know, we've just worked the strike. We're going to pick up another two there. It's tight. Our player is fucking rooted, but pick up two. Move on to 104. They got the field up right now, and we only need two off the remaining four balls. So this has been, yeah, an outstanding captain's knock. I'm pretty sure we're captain. We didn't try fucking scoop right there. You know the luck's running with you. That one could have easily just barreled into the stumps, but we got away with it. I really wanted to finish the game with that shot. It would have been nice, but we're going to finish very strongly straight down the ground. Just perfection. Almost six, just one bounce four. And that is going to be an outstanding win, an outstanding knock. What can you say? We got one over with the ball, I guess, you know, they saving us up for the bat. We were fresh, we were ready to go. And we pick up man of the match. Incredible stuff. You know, what can you say? Great stuff. Hopefully, guys are enjoying the series. Make sure to like if you are, and I'll see you guys next time.